Hello, my brothers and sisters in the Lord. How are you all? This is God Desires Mercy Than Sacrifice Movement from England. Today I've got a special topic which says, if you obey me, I will reveal myself to you and live with you, says Christ in John 14, 21 to 26. If you obey me, I will reveal myself to you, which means I will show myself to you, which Christ says. In many occasions, people go from different churches, seeking different prophets, different pastors, different visioners, to seek for Jesus Christ, different churches. But I tell you, like me, there were many messages that people gave me. If I had followed people's messages, those messages, and not testing it, I would have gone the wrong way. I would have made worst mistake in my life in many occasions. That is why somebody like me, I don't seek for prophecy from anybody. No matter what prophecy anybody gives me, I must test it. How do I test it? I must pray, God Almighty, please reveal this thing to me, so that I will know if it's really from you. Why? 1 John 4:1 says, test all spirits to make sure if they are from Lord, if they are from God. It says that many false prophets shall go out in the world to deceive many. It says that any spirit that believes that Christ has come as human being and die, it says that that spirit is from God. But remember, James chapter 2, verse 19, it says, do you believe in God? It says, yes. It says, even devil believes as well. So, anybody, any prophet can believe in God and tell you, oh, come, I will give you prophecy. I believe in God, this, that. But you still need to test every spirit to avoid false prophets. Once you go through his words to know how to obey him, I tell you, no spirit can come and tell you anything. Because in most cases, devil can use somebody can be getting messages from God. But if the person is not careful, devil can go into the person and even speak. You know, devil can go into somebody and speak. If somebody is not at watch, devil can troop in and speak. Evil spirits can go inside somebody to give message. That is why it is good for everyone who believes in the Lord to watch his or her mind, to walk with the Lord, to obey Christ. If you obey him, you are a prophet. You are a prophetess. You don't need anybody to give you messages. Christ reveals himself to those who obey him. So, if you use New Living Translation Bible for better understanding, to read the same John chapter 14, verse 21, it explains it well, more than how King James Version Bible and other Bible versions would explain it. This is what Jesus Christ says there. Those who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. And because they love me, my Father will love them. And I will love them and reveal myself to each of them. So you can see, he didn't say I will reveal myself to them through any pastor or through any prophet. But he says here, I will reveal myself to each of them. So all you need to do is to study all the words of Jesus Christ and obey them. He will reveal himself to you directly. In many occasions, he wouldn't need to reveal himself to you through any pastor or through any prophet. Those are the reasons why Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6, it says that God Almighty raised us with Christ and seated us on the heavenly realms. So, if you are seated on the heavenly realms, why do you seek for prophecy from one person to another? Only thing you need is to obey Christ, is to learn about him, is to learn about his words, is to learn how to obey him. Once you obey him, you don't need to seek prophecy from anybody, because Christ says that if you obey him, that he will reveal himself to you. According to John, what he says in the book of John 14, 21 to 24. Then if you come to 23, he says that if you come to 23 and 24, he says, dear, that if you obey him, that him, Christ, Jesus Christ, and God Almighty, his Father, will come to you and live. If God lives in you, why do you jump around seeking for prophecy from people? I tell you the truth. In the Old Testament, you needed people like Elisha, Elijah, Jeremiah, all of them, to be your mediator between you and God, to be your mouth, to be your voice between you and God. But have you taken your time to read Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 to 2? It says that in the beginning, God Almighty spoke to our ancestors through the prophets. It says, but he has spoken to us through Jesus Christ. Those are the reasons why in the book of the same John, chapter 14, if you read it from 6, Jesus Christ says there, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one shall go to Lord God Almighty except through me. In the same John chapter 14, Christ says in the book of, in the same John 14, verse 12, he says, any of you who believes in me shall do what I did, and even do greater things. What were the things that he did? Whilst he was in the world, he was a prophet, he was a seer, he was a healer, he was a good man. God has seated all of us, according to Ephesians chapter 2, verse 6, and rose us with Christ and seated us on the heavenly realms. So if you are seated on the heavenly realms, so why do you think that your fellow man is your mediator between you and God? Those are the reasons why. If you go to Hebrews chapter 5, verse 12, it says that now all of you would have been teachers, but that you are still eating baby's food. Those are the reasons why you have to respect everybody, but you fear only God. You follow only God as your way path. Those are the reasons why Christ says, if you use Good News Bible to read Matthew chapter 23, 8 to 12, it says, call no one on earth your father, or let no one call himself teacher, or rabbi, or messiah. It says that we are all equal. We are all equal through him. We only need Christ as messiah. People are going to places seeking him from one prophet to another. Some of the people that you go to occult to get power and be telling you all sorts of things. They can see everything in your life. They can know what is in your pocket, but they do not have solution. But if you come to Christ, he's the only one who has solution. He will tell you the truth without mixing anything. So what am I trying to tell you? If you obey Christ, he will reveal himself to you. How do you obey him? To learn how to love one another. As he says in the book of Luke, chapter 6, 27 to 37, he says, dear, even love your enemies. He says, because God loves them as well. Then he says, dear, condemn not, so that you shall not be condemned. Forgive, so that you shall not be forgiven. Then learn how to purify your heart. To obey Christ is not about going to church every Sunday or every Saturday. It is not only about that, but the main ingredients of obeying Christ is loving one another and loving God, according to what Christ says in the book of Mark 12, 28 to 34. If you can learn that, then if you want to learn all these things I said in deep, you can go to my website, which is called www.unforgivenessleadstohell.com. It will lead you well how to purify your heart. Notice, I am not here to campaign for anybody or to campaign for any church or to campaign for myself. I don't care about number. All I care is for people to do good things. I don't care. Once you learn through my website, you don't need to seek for me to give me a tithe or offering. You don't really need to follow me. Just know the words, the truth. Go to your house, anywhere. You can be a disciple of Christ, anywhere. My own is to make people to know Christ. Why? Because the true people of God do not evangelize for themselves. They evangelize for Christ. Learn how to purify your heart. You don't need to seek Him in different places. You don't need to go from one church to another. You are seeking for miracle. The miracle is in your doorstep. The miracle is within you. You don't need to go from place to place seeking for healing. The healing is within you. It's living in you. If you can obey Christ, the healing is with you. Just learn how to obey Christ. He has given us power to cast out demons. As Christ says in the book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 19, He says that He has given us power to overcome all the powers of darkness. But sometimes people don't see all this miracle because they do not follow Christ, because they follow after their own desire, because they follow after their own wish, because they do not want to learn about Christ. They follow all sort of pastors who do not really know much about Christ. Those are the reasons why Jesus Christ used His mouth and says in the book of Matthew 23, verse 15, if you use New Living Translation to read it, it says that many teachers of religious law go about making converts. After they made the converts, they turn the people into the people of hellfire, as they themselves are already. I wasn't the one who said, Jesus Christ said. So what am I trying to say? Learn about Jesus Christ before you can say that you are following anybody, so that you wouldn't get misled. Those are why Christ says in the book of John chapter 15, verse 7, that if you obey Him, that pray and ask Him anything, that He shall do it for you. But in most cases, many people do pray and nothing happens because they are filled with bitter heart towards others, unforgiveness, anger, sexual immoralities. All you need to do is to obey Christ. Whoever that obeys Christ, he wouldn't need to run from one church to another seeking for any pastor to pray for him or to do it for him, because he has already got the miracle once he prays.
Jeremiah 17 verse 5 to 9 says that only the heavenly Lord of Lords that can never fail you, but that any human being at all may fail you. So if Peter, our first pastor, ordained by Christ Himself, could deny Christ, and after the death of Christ, he was deceiving some Christ's followers. In Galatians chapter 2, verse 11 to 14, any pastor may deceive anybody also, like Peter did, if the pastor is not at watch. That is why everybody needs to be studying all the words of Christ in the Bible every day and be obeying them without depending on any human being, and without just only depending on any pastor at all, to be able to test our spirits, as 1 John 4:1 says. Pray daily that Christ leads you to heaven. He says in John 14 verse 6 to 24 that He is the only one that any human being needs to get to God Almighty, that any human being at all who is willing can do more than Him. So if you can do more than Christ, who has died for you in the New Testament, you can also do more than any pastor at all, if you can personally be studying all Christ's words in the Bible and obey them. So if you don't see a good church, start one from your house. Welcome everybody. For freely giving you all our messages, call us on 0044-7931-626513. Always click on the share button to share our preaching with everyone on different social media platforms in order to help them to make heaven. Our YouTube channel to follow us is called Apostle Ugo Ndu. May God Almighty bless you.